Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's spend a little time talking about intermediates in organic chemistry. Now, when we talk about reactions, we see over on the left a reaction coordinate diagram. We have a starting material. The reaction finishes at a product. And this, in particular, we've shown we have two humps, two steps in this reaction, two transition states, one transition state for each step. We can label those. So we'd have transition state one and transition state two. And then we have this low energy point in the middle, this little dip. This is an intermediate. I tend to think of intermediates as a stopping point on a long journey. You go on a long drive in a car, you might need to stop somewhere for gas before you can complete your journey. So the intermediate is kind of this stopping point, this temporary stopping point on the reaction coordinate diagram. Now, there in organic chemistry, we tend to talk about intermediates around carbon. So this video is really about the four carbon-based intermediates. And the first one is the carbocation. Carbocations are carbons with three bonds in which the carbon has a positive charge. This carbon does not have a full octet, so it's unstable. It's unstable, but it can have a lifetime. It has a lifetime, it's a dip in the curve, but it's unstable, it's going to continue on the pathway to make something else. So carbocations are typically sp2 hybridized because of the vacant p orbital on the carbon. Carbanions are much like carbocations, except for they have a lone pair, and that gives the carbon a negative charge. Carbanions are typically sp2 or sp3 hybridized. The types of carbanions that we encounter normally in introductory organic chemistry are sp2 hybridized, but they can be sp3. Carbanions, if they're sp2, what we're saying is that lone pair is actually in a p orbital, and it's in a p orbital because it can do resonance to other atoms next door, to pi bonds next door, to delocalize that charge. And that's why we tend to encounter sp2 hybridized carbanions in this course. Radicals are carbons with three bonds with an unpaired electron. Therefore, while that carbon still does not have a full octet, it also does not have a formal charge. Radicals are most commonly sp2 hybridized. The radical, that single electron, occupies a p orbital, unhybridized p orbital on carbon. And then carbenes are the last intermediate I'll mention. Carbenes are kind of odd things. They're a carbon with two bonds and a lone pair. These can be sp or sp2 hybridized. I tend not to present these in an introductory organic chemistry course. Just because I don't present them does not mean that they're not important in organic chemistry. In fact, they have a growing importance in organic chemistry. That importance just hasn't found a voice yet in a typical introductory organic chemistry curriculum. I want to highlight that carbanions and carbocations are both charged intermediates. And so any discussions that we've had about how do we stabilize or handle charges in molecules are very important and are going to come to the forefront when we talk about carbocations or carbanions. So those are the four carbon intermediates that are encountered in organic chemistry.